everyone, in this video, let's look at the hidden features of the Vivo V15 Pro. Now, there are so many settings that's actually deep hidden inside the settings. So, if you just tweak that and you can actually really customize your mobile phone very nicely. So, that's how Vivo provides a lot of features and settings. Now, I'll be showing a lot of different settings that will be really helpful to you. Now, before I begin this video, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button because it helps me make content, and please like and share this video as well. I'll be making a lot of interesting videos about the Vivo V15 Pro, so make sure you are subscribed to my channel. And also, I have made a lot of interesting contents about different mobile photography, so make sure you watch those videos as well. It might help you. So guys, the first setting that I'm going to show you is inside the settings. Now, let's move to the settings quickly, and here what you have to do is go to the about phone. So in order to do that, just tap on the more settings, and here you have to tap on about phone. Just keep tapping on the software version until the developer mode gets unlocked. So around it takes 5 taps. So after you have done that, your developer mode will be activated. Just take back, and again inside the more settings itself, at the bottom you will find this developer options. So click on the developer options. The first setting that I'm going to show you inside this developer option is to make sure you have enabled this one, otherwise it doesn't work. So just enable and say okay. So the first setting is here, memory. What this basically shows is the average memory usage. Now currently the mobile is using 3.4 GB out of 6 GB. That means average usage is 31%. Let's say that you are facing a lot of stutters while you are using mobile, lot of hanging problems, lot of apps get hanged, or rather it asks to force stop. What you can do is come back to this setting, memory use, and see that memory used by apps. So see that which app is using a lot of memory. So you can literally free up the memory space and make this phone run really, really fast. Now already it's having a 6 GB, but still if you are facing any problems, any slow in mobile, so you can always come back here and see. Let's say the Jovi Smart Scene is occupying a lot of space, a lot of memory space it's consuming. What you can do is just go back again. You need to go to the app manager, which is located in the settings. So this is settings here. So we will move to the app manager, which is again located inside the more settings. Here's the app manager. Tap on that. Here you should find that Jovi Smart Scene and then force stop it. So if you are not finding the system apps, just tap on this more. Just enable this system app. So now you will see all the system related apps as well. So just find that Jovi, or rather particular application that your mobile is consuming a lot of memory. So here's the Jovi Smart Scene. Just tap on that. Again, tap on the force stop. So this is what you have to do in order to free up the space, memory space that's consuming by your mobile. So this is very handy feature which is located, or rather hidden deep inside the settings menu. So the second setting I'm going to show you is again inside the developer mode. So let's move to the more settings, again developer options. So just tap on that, make sure this is enabled every time. So inside the developer options, just find the night mode, auto night mode. So here's the night mode, just tap on it and make sure it is set to automatic. So what this basically does is, if you set it to automatic, based on the time of the day, the colors turn warm so that it won't hurt your eyes. So that's a nifty feature. You can always turn the night mode right from here, but then you have to turn it, you have to switch it manually. So instead of doing that, you can always keep it to automatic. So as the day passes by, as the night approaches, it automatically turns to the warmer colors. The third setting we'll be looking is again inside the developer options. So again here, what we will do is to enable the camera laser sensor. Yes, as you can see, there is a camera laser sensor which is by default disabled. So make sure you enable it. So this is a very nice feature. What it basically does is uses the laser sensor for the camera to give better autofocus and decide the depth of field. So the background blur or the depth of field will be decided based on the using the laser sensor. So again, this is hidden, so you have to enable it. So by default it is disabled. That's very nice feature. So if you didn't know about this, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, guys. All right, moving on, the another setting that I'm going to show you quickly is again inside developer options. Here there is this cool temperature. So because this is an AMOLED display, as the days pass by, as you use it more and more, the color shifts to the warmer side, or rather the temperature shifts to the warmer side. What you can do is to enable this one, it will ensure that always it is running with the cooler temperature. That way you can see the whites to be pure white, not on the yellowish side. So if you are finding your display to be on the yellowish side, you can always change this color temperature. So the next setting is again inside the more settings. Here you will find the face beauty for video call. So if you are video calling a lot of times and you want your face to be beautified automatically by using Jovis assistance, then make sure you turn this on. By default it will be turned off, so make sure you enable it in order to enable the face beauty for video call feature. So again, moving on inside the settings, just tap on the more settings again. Here you should find recent apps. So here's the recent apps, just tap on that. Here's the blur display, blur the display of private content. Make sure these two are enabled, and to whatever application you want to blur. Let's say you are surrounded with a lot of people and you don't want to show the private stuff to them while you just tap this recent application. So as you can see, you can actually blur these kind of things. So as you can see, you cannot see my face properly because I have blurred it. So how it can be done is enable it from here. So this is how you do it. Let's say I enable it for the contacts. Let's say I enable it for the Facebook. So what happens is, next time when you just move to, or rather switch to other applications, it will actually be blurred like this and it won't be sharp as this, as you are seeing here. So this is a very handy feature, again located inside the settings, recent apps. So in this video, let's end it to this much, because there are a lot of settings that I'll be covering in another video that will be part 2 of this video. Make sure you watch that video. If you like these kind of videos, hit that like button. Make sure you change the settings that I said and enjoy your phone to the fullest. So guys, see you all in another video. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.